We have this question. If we are treating epilepsy, how often we need to measure the blood levels of the anti-seizure medications? Well, here is the thing. In treating epilepsy, we don't have to keep repeating the blood levels all the time. There are times that we need to do the blood levels. First, we do the blood levels at the beginning of the treatment to make sure that the patient is processing the medications correctly and the liver and the kidneys are processing very well, so we establish a baseline. Drop me any questions in the comments and I'll answer them the next time. So hopefully people don't think that I am a real estate agent like in the neighborhood. Anyways, and then the second thing is when we have patients who are on the medication for such a long time and all of a sudden they start having seizures, then we wonder, like, are they taking their medications or not? So we're doubting compliance. Then we can check the blood levels to make sure that the compliance is there. And then the third thing is that if we start a patient on a new anti-seizure medications in addition, so there is some interaction with the medications, then we can check the blood levels after that to kind of make sure there is no interaction between those. And for that, we always do monitoring medication by medication, and sometimes we do need to check the liver function, the kidney functions for those medications, and every medication has its own protocol for measurement and for follow-up for the specific medication in terms of side effects and effects on the liver and kidney and other areas. And to learn a lot about all the anti-seizure medications and how we can choose the best one of them, you can see this video and stay healthy and see you in the next one.